Welcome to Decoded by Christina Minutes. Today, I'm going to talk about grid template columns and grid auto columns. When using a CSS grid layout, grid items are displayed as one column per row. Use grid template columns to add more columns. For example, two values will create two columns and will also form an explicit grid. They can be set to the same or different sizes. Now let's say I want four columns, with each column width alternating between 100 pixels and 50 pixels. Two more values will create two more columns. Another option is to use an implicit grid, which auto-places grid items that are added outside of the explicitly defined tracks. There are a couple ways to do this. The natural flow of items in the grid is to be displayed in rows. So start by using grid auto flow set to column to auto-place items by column. Next, define a number of rows with grid template rows. Two values will define the size of two rows. They can be the same or different sizes as well. Four columns will automatically be created in the implicit grid to fit within the two rows, which were explicitly defined. If I add two more items, there will now be five columns to fit within the two defined rows. But what if you didn't want to define the number of rows, or you want to define different column sizes? Let's take a look at option two. Instead of defining an explicit number of rows, define the number of columns with grid template areas. The values can be assigned using any name you want rather than a size value, which creates an implicit grid. If I use two values, it will create two columns. Then use grid auto columns to define the size. One value will automatically size all the columns. A second value will size the second column, and so on. This pattern will automatically repeat if more columns are added to the grid template areas. To learn more about these grid properties, check out the MDN documentation listed in the video description.